friends, in last video trigonometric ratio part 1, in that one we have learned about the trigonometric ratio, and we are just taking here one example, related example to the trigonometric ratio. Here it is given, cos theta is equal to 7 upon 8, evaluate 1 plus sin theta, 1 minus sin theta, we have to evaluate 1 plus sin theta, it is given, and 1 minus sin theta upon 1 plus cos theta and 1 minus cos theta. Here we have to evaluate this one. Here we have two methods. One is we will put the value of cos theta. If cos theta is not given, so we can find the value of sin theta, cos theta and other trigonometric functions. But here what we will do, first of all we will solve this one, then we will put the value. Now see, 1 plus sin theta, 1 minus sin theta, we have an identity, that is a plus b and a minus b is equal to a square minus b square. We know that this one, this identity we can use here. This is 1 plus sin theta and 1 minus sin theta. Here we can take here 1 square minus sin square theta upon same 1 plus cos theta and 1 minus cos theta. 1 plus cos theta, 1 minus cos theta is equal to 1 square minus cos square theta, a square minus b square is equal to 1 minus sin square. One more thing we have, that sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. So here we need 1 minus sin square. So you can see here cos square theta will be equal to 1 minus sin square theta. We can put this cos square at the place of 1 minus sin square. So here 1 minus sin square is equal to cos square theta upon, similarly 1 minus cos square theta, when we take in that side, that will be equal to sin square theta. So 1 minus cos square is equal to sin square theta. Now see, cos square upon sin square, that will be equal to cos theta upon sin theta whole square. We can write like this. And next, cos theta upon sin theta, we know that cos theta upon sin theta is equal to cos theta. So cos theta upon sin theta will be equal to cos theta, and whole square is there. We can take this square here, so that is cos, or let's put the value of cos from here. Cos theta is given 7 upon 8, so take a 7 upon 8, 7 upon 8 whole square, that will be equal to 7 ja 49 and 8 ja 64. Now this is the value of 1 plus sin theta, 1 minus sin theta upon 1 plus cos theta and 1 minus cos theta. Now we will learn trigonometric ratio between 0 to 90 degree. Before that I would like to say, if you did not subscribe this channel, please subscribe and ring the bell icon also, so that you can get the notification whenever I will upload new videos. Now see, this is sin theta, these are the angles, sin theta, cos theta, tan, cot, sec and cosec, and these are 0, 3. What is the value of these trigonometric function on these degrees? So how to make this table? Now let's see. First of all, we will have to learn 1, 2, 3, 4. Here we will write first of all 0, 1, 2, 3. 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4 here. After that, it is easy way to learn. Easy way to learn on this table. Now divide by 4 everywhere. Upon 4, upon 4, upon 4 and upon 4. And take square root of each and every one. Like this. Now what is value? We will find here, fill everywhere here one by one. 0 upon 4 under root is equal to 0. 1 upon 4 is equal to 1 upon 2. When we will take a square root, so here what will come? 1 upon 2. Next one is 2 upon 4. 2 under 2, 2 under 4. So this will come as 1 upon under root 2. So 1 upon under root 2. 1 upon under root 2. Next one is 3 upon 4. So if we can write here under root 3 and the square root of 4 is 2. So we can write here under root 3 upon 2.
And next one is 4 upon 4 means 1, and we can write here 1. This is the value of sine theta on different degrees 0, 30, 45, 60, and 90. Now cos theta, take opposite of the sine theta. Here 0, 1 upon 2, these are written. Take this one first. 1. Next one is under root 3 upon 2. Here 1 upon under root 2. Next 1 upon 2. And next one is 0. Now it is very easy way to make this table. No need to learn, no need to mug up, no need to take in your mind. Always you can make any time, anywhere. Now next one is tan theta. We know tan theta is equal to sin theta upon cos theta. Sin theta upon cos theta means this is sin theta, this is cos theta for 0 degree. 0 upon 1. 0 upon 1 is equal to 0. Next 1 upon 2. 1 upon 2 divided by means upon under root 3 upon 2. So we can write here 2 upon under root 3 like this. When we will multiply, we will divide, it will reciprocal. So here what will come here? 2 to 2 cancel, 1 upon under root 3 will come here. Next one, same 1 upon 2 upon 1 upon 2 sine upon cos, that will, what will come here? 1. And under root 3 upon 2 divided by 1 upon 2, what will come here? Under root 3. Next one, 1 upon 0. 1 upon 0 is equal to infinitive. Infinitive means not defined. The meaning of this infinitive, not defined. Not defined. We cannot define this one. Next one, cot theta is the inverse of tan theta, as we know. Inverse of tan theta, you can take inverse of theta also and take it opposite as it is. First of all, take last one, take first, that is infinity, then under root 3, then 1, then 1 upon under root 3, and then here 0. Now sec theta. Sec theta, as we know, sec theta is the inverse of cos theta. 1 upon cos theta is equal to sec theta. Take inverse of this one. 1 upon 1 is equal to 1 only. Opposite, take reciprocal of this one, that is 2 upon under root 3. Reciprocal of this one, that is under root 2 upon 1 or under root 2 only, we can say. Here 1 upon 2 means 2 upon 1 or 2 only. And 0, this is 0, so 1 upon 0 we will take. 1 upon 0 means infinity. So this is also not defined. This is. So we have done here. This is also not defined, and this is also. Now we can take the cosec theta, and cosec theta is the inverse of sine theta, or you can take inverse of this one also. Inverse of sine theta is equal to infinity, then you can take here 2, take reverse of this one also, and this one also you can take. So take here 2, then next one is under root 2, the next one is 2 upon under root 3, and last one is 1. This is the way to make the table. So no need to mug up this one. We can make any time, anywhere by this method. Listen again. First of all, we write 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, divide 4, 4, 4 everywhere, and then solve that one. Then similarly, you can do rest. Now let us take one example of this degree. That is one example I am taking here. Suppose it is given sine 60 degree, cos 30 degree, then plus sine 30 degree, plus sine 30 degree, and multiply by cos 60 degree. It is given. We want to find the value of this one, other, or we evaluate this one. How to evaluate this one? We know just before we have done that table. In that one, the value of sine 60 degree, you can see sine 60 degree is equal to under root 3 upon 2. Right? Under root 3 upon 2 at the place of this. Multiply the value of cos 30, that is 1 upon 2, plus then sine 30 degree. Sine 30 degree is equal to, sorry, cos 30 degree is also 1 under root 3 upon 2. Under root 3 upon 2. Cos 30 degree, sine 30 degree, sine 30 degree is equal to 1 upon 2 from that table, and cos 60 degree, that is also 1 upon 2, like this. So these are the value of these one. Now what to do? According to Gordon's rule, first of all we will have to multiply under root 3 into under root 3, that will be equal to 3, and 2 into 2 is equal to 4, and plus 1 into 1 is equal to 1 upon 2 into 2 is equal to 4. Now you can take like this, LCM, 4 you can take, this is 3 plus 1 is equal to 4 upon 4 is equal to 1. Now this is the value of this question, this is the solution. Now here one more example we are taking, related example. Here it is given 2 tan 45 degree upon 1 plus tan square 45 degree. We have to solve this one. So see here, that will be equal to 2 tan 45 degree. Sorry, tan 45 degree. What is the value of 45 tan 45 degree? According to the table, tan 45 is equal to 1. So take here 1 at the place of tan 45, and here again 1 plus tan square 45 degree. We can take like this, tan 45 degree and square like this. So here 2 into 1 is equal to 2, and 1 plus tan 45 degree again, that is 1. So 1 square is equal to 2 upon 1 plus 1 equal 1 plus 1 is equal to 2, and that is 1. This is the answer of the this question. Now in next video we will learn trigonometric ratio of the complementary angle. Complementary angle, the sum of two angles is equal to 90 degree, that these angles are called complementary angle. So we will learn about it. And before this I would like to say, if you did not subscribe this one, so please subscribe, share and like this one, so that other also can learn. And if you did not subscribe, you also please subscribe and ring the bell icon also, so that you can get notification whenever new video I upload. We will learn more. Thank you very much.